Hi, I'm Jesse Kinnifin from Movitherm, and this is a demonstration of our IR control software solution for detecting the presence of glue beads. To start, I'm going to use a recorded sequence of thermal images to configure my inspection. As I play through the image sequence, you can see there are 8 hot glue beads present in the frame. At 2 points in time during the sequence, I cover a glue bead with a cold piece of cardboard to hide its heat signature, which simulates an absence of a glue bead on an assembly line, such as when a glue dispensing machine stops working properly. The thermal images are currently displayed in a grayscale palette. We can change the palette to display the heat gradients more clearly. Now the temperatures are displayed in a gradient from blue to yellow, with blue being the coldest temperatures and yellow being the hottest. We have the option to manually adjust the scale by double-clicking on each endpoint of the range slider. The max and min can be independently set to auto or manual mode. The temperature units are currently set to degrees C. To work in another unit such as Fahrenheit, we simply go to the top menu and select Options, System, and then click on the Units tab and select Fahrenheit. Now we are ready to configure our inspection and to detect the presence of the two beads I covered up during the sequence. Using the Area of Interest tools, I create a rectangle around each bead of interest and label them. Going clockwise from the top, I will refer to them as beads 2 and 8. Now I'll move to the function field and right-click and select Add. Here I can configure the parameters for a particular area of interest, such as the one I've labeled bead 2, to which I will activate a flag when a certain case is met. For bead 2, I want to activate the flag when the maximum temperature in the area of interest is greater than 111 degrees Fahrenheit. Here I will enable out 1, or digital output line 1, which is mapped to a particular port and line on the digital I/O board in my PC. Now in the function field, the function I've just created has a little red box around it, meaning that the case is currently met. When it turns green, the case is not met. As I scroll through the sequence frames, we can see that the case is no longer met when the cardboard covers bead 2. Now I'll add the same conditions to bead 8's area of interest, only this time I'll map its flag to out 2 and verify that it works. Looks good. Now I'll move to live mode and activate and enable the digital I/O lines that I've configured. The leftmost LED is configured to be on when I'm in live mode. The middle LED is now mapped to bead 2, and the rightmost LED is now mapped to bead 8. We can see as the cardboard covers a bead, the corresponding LED turns off, indicating that the bead is no longer present in the frame. That completes the demo. Thanks for watching.